So we need to find the volume of a solid whose base is the region bounded by the curves a minus x squared and x squared, and whose cross sections are equilateral triangles perpendicular to the x-axis. The area of one equilateral triangle equals the side squared times the square root of 3 over 4, which in our case equals the difference between our two functions. All squared times square root of 3 over 4. The volume of this triangle will equal its area times its depth, which is dx. And to find the volume of the whole solid, we need the sum of all the volumes of all the triangles in this figure. And to find out the bounds of this integral, we need to set the expressions equal to each other. And we get a equals 2x squared, x squared equals 4, x equals 2, and x equals minus 2. So our bounds are minus 2 and 2. And the side of each triangle equals 8 minus x squared minus x squared all squared times square root of 3 over 4 times dx. We can start to solve for the value of our antiderivative, and to start we can take this coefficient out of the expression. Expression in parentheses as 8 minus 2x squared all squared times dx. Now we can start to simplify the expression in the parentheses. We get 64 minus 32x squared plus 4x to the 4 times dx. Now we can take the antiderivative of each individual term. We get 64x minus 32/3x to the third plus 4 over 5x to the fifth on the integral from negative 2 to 2. In order to find the volume of the solid, we need to find the value of f at both of these bounds. So at 2, f equals square root of 3 over 4 times 64 over 2 minus 32 over 3 2 cubed plus 4 over 5 x to the fifth, which can be rewritten as 156 square root of 3 over 15. Now f of negative 2 equals square root of 3 over 4 times negative 64 times 2 plus 32 over 3 times 2 cubed plus 4 over 5 times 2 cubed, which is the opposite of this number, so it equals negative 256 times the square root of 3 over 4. And now to find out the volume with the solid, we need to subtract f of negative 2 out of f of 2, which is equal to 256 square root of 3 over 15 minus negative 256 square root of 3 over 15, which equals 512 times square root of 3 over 4, which is approximately equal to 59.12.